was great in the land.
Come on.
It was trouble, amen.
Yes, sir.
It was a city that there was not one person in town that wasn't homosexual.
Amen.
It was totally given over to homosexuality.
Amen.
You were either a gay, in which I don't no person that's homosexual is gay, amen.
That's right,
Bishop.
Because you're not happy.
Not at all.
Happiness comes from God.
Right.
And you can't be happy outside of God.
That's
right.
But the whole city was given over to homosexuality.
Amen.
There was not a straight man in Sodom.
Wow.
There was not a straight woman in Sodom. It was all lesbians, homosexuals in the whole town. The mayor was a homosexual.
All right, look at that.
The ruler of the city was a homosexual. Everybody was a homosexual. The governor was a homosexual. The alderman was a homosexual. The city clerk was a homosexual. The police officers were a homosexual. The whole city was given over.
All right.
So God was going to destroy this city. But he sent a warning before he did it. He sent Abraham.
Yes.
Told him, I'm going to show you what I'm about to do.
Yes.
My friend, amen, as we go on with this message, God will destroy a city,
yes, sir,
a town, a country, because sin, when it gets so grievous in the sight of God, God will wipe it off of the mountain.
Yes, he will.
Tell me what it say, daughter. Tell me what it say.
Okay. He smote the men that were at the door of the house with blindness.
He smote those men because two angels, because see, God doesn't do anything without a witness.
Amen.
God always sends a warning.
Mm-hmm.
So after the angels left Abraham's house, they headed towards Sodom.
Amen.
Their mission was to destroy Sodom.
Amen.
To check it out and see if it was as wicked as it had been heard coming up before God. Tell me what he said, daughter.
Both small and great.
All right. So when the angels got there, because, amen, those angels did not act like the rest of them.
Mm-hmm.
They noticed that there were new men in town.
Right.
There's some strangers in town.
Amen with them. Corrupted them yet.
They wanted to get those strangers. Y'all don't want to say
come
nothing.
Come on.
Go ahead.
Tell me what he said, daughter.
Come on. So that they wearied themselves to find the door.
So when the angels reach out, when the demons, when the people of Sodom,
yes,
saw those men,
uh-huh,
they wanted to go get them.
Yes.
Yes.
At Lot's house.
That's right.
Yes. So when they went up to Lot's house to get them, the angels smote them with blindness.
Yes. Amen.
Talk yes to me, daughter.
Amen.
And the men said unto Lot.
And the men said unto Lot.
Hast thou here any besides?
Hast thou here any besides?
Son-in-law.
Your son-in-law.
And thy son.
And thy son.
And thy daughter.
Uh-huh.
And whatsoever thou hast in the city, bring them out of this place.
Bring them out of this place. Uh-huh.
For we will destroy this place, because the cry of them is waxing great before the face of the Lord.
The cry is waxing great, yeah, in the sight of God.
Uh-huh.
God, see, there are many sins, but there are some sins that's absolutely detestable in the sight of God.
Amen.
God will destroy a city, a country, a town.
Yes.
Because when things get so great,
yes,
God will take it down.
Amen.
He will take down a nation.
All right.
You talk about a cyber attack. You talk about, amen, that ain't nothing compared to a heavenly attack. Amen.
Right now.
God can take two angels and destroy a country. Y'all don't want to hear
amen
me.
Amen.
Tell me what it say, daughter.
And the Lord have sent us to destroy it.
And the Lord sent them.
Mm-hmm.
Two angels.
Yes.
Just two angels.
Yes. Amen.
To destroy this city.
Yes.
But Abraham was the man of God.
Yes.
He stood in the gap.
Come
on. Saying, repent, all of you.
All right.
And he asked God, he tried to kind of bargain with God.
Yes.
Said, Lord, if you find 50 righteous men,
uh-huh,
if you can just find 50 men in town that ain't homosexual, if you can find 50 women that ain't lesbian,
uh-huh,
will you spare the city?
My God.
Will you spare? God said, yes, I'll spare it. But everywhere he looked, there was nothing but homosexuality.
Mercy, Lord.
He said, oh Lord, pre-adventure, if I find 40,
my God,
will you spare the city?
Jesus.
If you find 40, I'll spare it. But he couldn't find 40 straight men in a whole city.
My God.
They were all fruit of the loom. A city that's totally given. Now let me show you something.
Give it over to it. My God.
Not only was that city, but it spread out.
Yes.
Yes, it did.
To surrounding cities.
Yes, it did.
Let me say this. When Lot's son-in-laws went down there with his wives, they were married. When they got married in Sodom or somewhere along the line, they got married. Because Lot said, I have two daughters that don't even know a man. So they might have got married in Sodom. But let me tell you something. When they got ready to leave Sodom, because of the association of the gays that were in Sodom, those two men did not want to leave, amen. They did not leave. So when two men adopt a child, you put your two men spirit on that child.
Come on, Bishop. Right.
Two women adopt a child, you put your lesbian wicked spirit up on that child.
Come on.
Go
ahead.
It is wrong in the sight of God.
Amen.
Because you are forcing your lifestyle on that child.
Come on. Tell it. Tell it.
It's a spirit that's got you and won't let you go. And you put it on your child.
Come on,
the same spirit, amen, that was up on Sodom men got up on my son-in-law.
Right.
And they would rather have a man than to stay with his wife. When Lot told them about leaving town, they thought he was talking crazy, amen.
My God.
So the spirit, there's a spirit that gets in folks. And you release that spirit up on two daddies trying to raise a child.
Come on.
That's backwards.
Amen.
Tell me what it say, daughter.
And Lot went out.
And Lot went out.
And spake unto his son-in-law.
And spake unto his son-in-laws.
Which married his daughters.
Which married his daughters.
And said.
And said.
Up. Get you out of this place.
Get out of this place.
For the Lord will destroy this city.
God will destroy this city.
But he seemed as one that mocked unto his son-in-law.
They went in straight and came out backwards.
Come out.
Come on, you understand? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. All right, tell me what it says.
And when the morning arose.
And when the morning arose.
Then the angels hastened Lot, saying,
Arise. See, because one problem is, in the first place, God did not call Lot.
Right.
He called Abraham.
Amen. Yes, he did. Amen.
Abraham chose Lot, amen.
Yeah. That's right.
And God didn't bless him until he let Lot go, amen.
Come on.
Y'all don't want to hear him. See, a lot of people out there, listen, you're trying to preach and teach and ain't got the baptism. Well,
come on.
Go somewhere and get the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen.
God don't cut no corners. He said he'll do a quick work. He'll do a quick work on you and baptize you with the Holy Ghost.
Come on.
In a hurry, if you repent, amen.
Come on.
You got to have it.
That's right.
He never sent out one disciple that didn't have the Holy Ghost.
No.
Amen.
He told him, say, go ye into Jerusalem and wait there.
Yeah.
Right.
Until you be endued with power.
Amen.
From on high. Come on, daughter, tell me what it says.
Arise. Take thy wife.
Take your wife.
And thy two daughters.
And your two daughters.
Which are here. Lest thou be consumed in the iniquity of the city.
In the iniquity of the cities. Now, do you notice the son-in-laws ain't going nowhere? They have made up their mind.
Amen.
A spirit of homosexual have got on them.
Yes.
And they want to stay there. As a matter of not want to, they stayed there.
Yes, they did. Amen.
The word is pleading with you to come out of that lifestyle.
Yes.
Go ahead, Bishop.
Because God will destroy you. And if our presidents, if our senators, authorities vote for such a thing, God will cause destruction
Amen.
To come up on our country.
Amen.
Y'all hear me?
Amen.